G'day mates, this is an emergency broadcast episode. You've all heard about the bushfires in Australia. They've been going on ever since September, and they've burned like 11 million acres, and this is about kangaroos. The kangaroos are pretty endangered as well. They're in trouble because Australia is home to 50 million kangaroos and only 20 million people, so there's 2.5 times more kangaroos than there are people. And the bushfires have only killed like 30 people, but who knows how many kangaroos they've killed. But I can guarantee you a lot more than the 30 people that have been killed. I just hope not in the millions, because that could be severe to the kangaroo population, because some species of kangaroos are already endangered, and we've already lost some species of kangaroos in the past, like the giant short-faced kangaroo, and we don't want to lose any more. Our goal today is to prevent extinction, not let it happen again. So if we want to help these kangaroos, we've got to think of something, and think of it fast. Here's some stuff about kangaroos quickly. The largest kangaroo in the world is the red kangaroo, of course, 7 feet tall, 300 pounds. Very fast, capable of hopping up to 50 miles an hour, cover 50 feet in one leap, and jump 11 feet straight up in the air. There's lots of different kinds of kangaroos. Like, there's kangaroos, wallabies, wallaroos, tree kangaroos. The largest member of the kangaroo family that ever lived was the giant short-faced kangaroo Procoptodon, 10 feet tall, 530 pounds. It was also the tallest marsupial that ever lived. And there were even some carnivorous kangaroos in the past that were about 5 feet tall, and they hunted live animals. And most marsupials live in Australia. There used to be lots of marsupials in South America too, but now the opossum's the only one left in the Americas, because what's strange is the placental mammals outcompeted the marsupials in South America, but in Australia it was the opposite, the other way around. When the Isthmus of Panama formed 5 million years ago, placentals from North America migrated south, and marsupials from South America migrated north. Like, for example, the saber-toothed tiger, a placental from North America, migrated south, and Thylacosmilus, a marsupial from South America, migrated north, and they came eye to eye with one another, and they were kind of similar to each other. It's kind of similar to each other because Thylacosmilus had cane saber teeth just like the saber-toothed tiger, but the saber-toothed tiger outcompeted Thylacosmilus. And just to let you know, Thylacosmilus was the biggest carnivorous marsupial that ever lived. 6 feet long and 1/4 ton with 7-inch canines. But the biggest marsupial that ever lived was ancestor of the wombat called Diprotodon. It was 12 feet long, 7 feet tall, weighed 4 tons. Much bigger than the largest marsupial alive today, which is, again, the red kangaroo. These bushfires are bigger than any other fires Australia has ever had in history, even more than in the past. And we already know what happened to the Australian megafauna during the last ice age in the past. If this is even worse, then even more species could go extinct than what happened in the last ice age. And the koalas could also share the same fate as their cousins, the kangaroos. We really have to figure out some way to put out these fires and save these animals, including kangaroos and koalas. We don't want the modern day kangaroo, to end up like its ancestor, the giant short-faced kangaroo, and we don't want the koala to end up like its carnivorous cousin, the marsupial lion. So far, scientists have estimated that these bushfires have killed over 1 billion animals, mostly mammals, but it also includes birds and reptiles. And we don't want any more animals to die, because 1 billion is way too many. And if you'd like to help, there are these links at the bottom of this page where you can check out, and these websites to see, figure out how you can help these animals and donate.